this video, we are going to discuss about backward bending asana with physiological explanation. Friends, usually our daily activities are often associated with forward bending. We seldom bend back for any reason. In order to maintain health, our body requires backward bending also. Backward bending postures reposes and strengthens the entire nervous system along with vital organs of the body. Friends, they also re-energizes the muscles and regulates the metabolism of the body. So, let us see how this backward bending asana works. Backward bending asana and digestive and nervous systems. Encourages good digestion. Good digestion refers to efficient working of gastrointestinal tract. Backward bending asana increases the rate of peristalsis movement in the stomach, small intestine and large intestine. This asana pushes the intestinal contents into the direction of anus before slowing down and allows these contents to be propelled more quickly and easily towards anus. As a result, the digestion becomes fast and efficient. In this way, backward bending asana encourages good digestion. Our second point is reduces abdominal fat. But how? Due to lack of physical activity, poor dietary habits and stress, the entire digestive system becomes sluggish. In that condition, disproportionate amount of fat is unevenly accumulated in the abdominal region. Backward bending asana, which are usually associated with stretching of abdominal muscles, requires more strength and energy to perform. For this purpose, body begins to consume stored fat from the abdominal region by converting it into glycerol and fatty acids. Glycerol is converted to glucose and then further breakdown releases energy. Simultaneously, fatty acids are also break down into hydrogen and carbon dioxide, which also releases energy. This energy is utilized by the muscles for the contraction and movement. By this way, backward bending asana reduces abdominal fat. Alleviates lower back pain. When stagnant stools are accumulated in the large intestine, then the process of absorption becomes slow. This decreases intestinal absorption of dietary vitamins and minerals. Shortage of these leads to decrease the rate of depolarization in the membrane potential within the cell and slowly generates action potential. This results weak nerve impulse transmission to muscles, which provokes pain in the lower back as it is proximal to large intestine also. Backward bending asana stretches the abdominal muscles, which pushes arthritis relieves from lumbar slip disc. Intervertebral discs are the soft tissues containing nucleus pulposus at the center and annulus fibrosus surrounding the center, which have certain thickness located between the adjacent vertebrae. The range of movement of the vertebral column is limited by the thickness, elasticity, and compressibility of these vertebral discs. These also act as a shock absorbers. In overweight and heavy lifters, the pulpy nucleus flattens and the annulus bulges when weight is applied, as occurs during standing and more so during lifting. Due to excessive forward movements, the nucleus pulposus serves as a support and the annulus is simultaneously placed under compression, slides to one side, usually called slip disc. Backward bending asana reduces the pain that occurred due to the nerve root and relocates the position of central part of the disc with sustained flexions of the vertebral column. In this way, backward bending asana relieves from lumbar slip disc. Backward bending asana with other systems. Promotes proper functioning of kidneys. Backward bending is a natural range of motion for the spine, which increases its suppleness and flexibility. This involves compression and stimulation of internal organs like kidneys, which are located just below the ribs at the back and posterior to abdomen. Gentle compression and pressure on kidneys provides opportunity to filter the blood in an effective way and regulates major hormones secreted by adrenal glands. In this way, backward bending asana promotes proper functioning of kidneys. Next point is relieves from menstrual discomforts. Usually, menstrual discomforts are associated with abdominal cramps and lower back pain also. These arise due to excessive contraction in the uterus to get rid of uterine lining by limiting the supply of oxygen to the nearby muscles, which radiates pain through the web of nerves within the pelvic region. During backward bending asana, extension occurs in the frontal plane of abdominal area, which covers abdomen and pelvic regions. This encourages optimum blood supply to the pelvic region and nourishes the reproductive organs, urinary bladder, and lower part of the intestines. In this way, this asana relieves from menstrual discomforts. Releases muscular tensions of back and legs. The condition in which the muscle length shortens and the tension on the muscle remains constant throughout the contraction refers to muscular tension. It is usually associated with stress, anxiety, and sedentary lifestyle. Backward bending asana, like dhanurasana, exerts sustained pressure on regions of lower back from L1 to S1 area, which innervates pelvic organs and legs. This asana elongates the contraction of muscles and propels proper blood flow throughout the back and leg, which provides high relaxation to the muscles. By this way, backward bending asana releases muscular tensions. Last point, eliminates chest congestion. Due to prolonged improper sitting postures, the entire thoracic cavity is compressed and the breathing becomes shallow. This causes lack of proper oxygen supply to the lungs, arousing a feeling of tightness, that is chest congestion, along with other allied problems also. Backward bending asana like ustrasana expands the rib cage, stretches the diaphragm and allows air into lungs freely and deeply. Due to expansion of muscles of the chest, diaphragm and ribs, they support deep breathing, which delivers more oxygen to the lungs. In this way, backward bending asana improves efficiency of respiratory muscles and eliminates chest congestion. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to our channel for all the updates. Do also remember to give your comments and share this video for awareness about yoga.